Hi everyone, welcome to Loki Medicine. In this video, I'll discuss about the general introduction of neurons, how neurons communicate, parts of neurons, their classification on the basis of structure and on the basis of functions. So without any further delay, let's get started. Neurons have some unique functions that form the basis for the powerful information processing capabilities of the nervous system. They are specialized for transmitting and receiving information, they can communicate with one another as well as with cells in other type of tissues like muscles and glands. They can also receive sensory information from the rest of the body to the brain. Current estimates suggest that there are about 86 billion neurons in the human body, over 1,000 of different types. It's important to note that neurons come in all shapes and sizes. They have classified on the basis of structure, they are classified on the basis of their function, which we will discuss later. So neuron can be defined as structural and functional unit of nervous system. Most neurons use electrical and chemical signals to send messages throughout the brain. They can generate and transmit nerve impulses, messages, informations, signals from brain to other parts and vice versa. This transmission and generation is known as action potential. Action potential is defined as when charged particles called ions flow into neurons and generate an electric impulse. They can travel from one end of neuron to another. There are two types of nerve impulses. Number one is the electrical impulse and number two is the chemical impulse. Electrical impulse is generated within the neuron. For example, dendrite receive information, then it passes to the cell body or soma, then to the axon, and then to the axon terminal. This whole transmission of nerve impulse is known as electrical impulse. When this information passes to the nerve endings or axon terminal, it releases a chemical known as neurotransmitter. Then this neurotransmitter attaches to the receptor of another dendrite, then to the cell body, then to the axon, then to another axon terminal, then it releases the same chemical neurotransmitter, then it attaches to another dendrite. This process goes on. So this generation of nerve impulse within the neuron is known as electrical, and between the neurons by the release of neurotransmitter is known as chemical nerve impulse. So these are the two types of nerve impulses. So moving towards the structure of neuron, as we can see that these branch-like extensions coming out from the circular body, or you can say the soma, is called as dendrites. Dendrites come from the Greek word which means tree-like. As you can see that its projections are like tree, so it is named as dendrite. So or we can say that dendrites carry information towards the cell. And to accomplish this, it has proteins called receptors on the surface where neurotransmitter reacts. They can generally be considered as the input area of the cell. Next, we have soma or cell body. Soma is another Greek word meaning body. Soma is the metabolic center containing nucleus, DNA, organelles. There are also nacelle bodies present inside the soma, which are same like ribosomes in other type of cells. Next, you can see the hill-like structure known as axon hillock. When information is received by dendrites, electrical properties of cell changes. Axon hillock is where those changes integrates, or simply you can say that it triggers the action potential. As axon hillock triggers the action potential, so impulse reaches to axon hillock will travel down through axon at a very rapid speed. We can say that 100 to 200 meters per second, where axon is the functional part of the neuron, functional part, which is defined as it carries information away from the cell. For example, this is the cell body. Dendrites is taking information towards the cell, and axon is taking information away from the cell. If we consider this neuron as the neuron of peripheral nervous system, we can say that Schwann cells are present, which forms the myelin sheath around the axon. Myelin sheath is the lipid-rich insulator material which speeds up the conduction and prevents ion leakage. What it does is that it prevents the ion leakage and speeds up the conduction. There are gaps between myelin sheath known as nodes of Ranvier. The basic function of nodes of Ranvier is that it is important for speeding up the impulse. At the end of axon, there are branches known as terminal or synaptic boutons. For example, these are the branches which are known as axon terminal, or we can say that synaptic bouton. There are also synaptic knobs present at the end of axon terminal. Synaptic knob basically possesses synaptic vesicles which contains the neurotransmitters like acetylcholine, etc., from where it releases the chemicals, neurotransmitter, and then attaches to the receptors of another dendrites. The space between neurons is very tiny and is known as synaptic cleft. Axon terminal, synaptic boutons, synaptic knobs, all these structures are very close to the next neuron, dendrites. They communicate with each other neurons through synapses. Let me explain it to you. This is the neuron present. There is another neuron present here. I am talking about this space. This space between neurons is very tiny and is known as synaptic cleft. Usually it's between 20 to 30 nanometers. The neuron whose axon terminal ends at synaptic cleft is presynaptic neuron, and the neuron on the other end is called postsynaptic neuron. For example, this neuron is ending. It is known as presynaptic neuron. And this neuron is receiving the neurotransmitter and it's the start. So it is known as postsynaptic neuron. When action potential reaches the axon terminal, it releases a chemical known as neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft. Then these released neurotransmitter binds to the postsynaptic neuron. So that's all about the structure of neuron. Moving towards the classification of neurons, we have classified neurons on the basis of their structure and on the basis of their functions. Firstly, we discussed classification on the basis of their function. We classified into three main categories: motor, sensory, and interneurons. Motor neurons are also known as afferent neurons. It carries information or motor response from the central nervous system to the peripheral nervous system. It has long axon, short dendrites, and multipolar neuron. On the other hand, sensory neurons are also known as efferent neurons because it takes information from the peripheral nervous system to the central nervous system. As compared to the motor neuron, they have short axon, long dendrites, and they are monopolar, or you can say the unipolar neurons. Moving towards the interneurons, interneurons form connection between the other two types of neurons, and they are also multipolar. Intersubdivisions are projection or relay interneurons, or you can say the local interneurons. Projection or relay interneurons have long axon and carries information for long distances, for example, from one part of the brain to another. On the other hand, local interneurons, they have short axons and form connections with nearby neurons. So that's all about the classification on the basis of their function. Now we have another classification on the basis of their structure. On the basis of their structure, we have classified neurons as multipolar neuron, unipolar neuron, and bipolar neuron. Multipolar neurons have single axon with many dendrites. For example, if we consider this as multipolar neuron, they have single axon and they have multiple dendrites. So it is considered as multipolar neuron. And as we discussed earlier, that motor neurons are multipolar neurons. Next we have unipolar neurons. They have basically one extension with multiple branches. For example, one is axon and one is dendrite. Example, this is axon and this is dendrites. Next we have bipolar neuron. Bi means two, so it has two extensions, one axon and one dendritic structure. Usually sensory systems rely on bipolar neurons, so it has this is dendrites and this is axon and this is cell body or soma. Next we have one more type, which is known as pseudo-unipolar neuron. Initially this neuron is bipolar, but later the axon and dendrites fuse together, so it carries sensory information like touch from parts of the body to the central nervous system. So that's all about the types on the basis of their structure. Now quickly summarize with me. We discussed that structure and functional unit of nervous system is the neuron. Neurons use chemical and electrical signals to send messages, so they generate two types of nerve impulses. Number one is electrical nerve impulse and chemical nerve impulse. Electrical is within the neuron and chemical is between neurons. Next, we discussed about the structure of neuron. It consists of dendrite, cell body, axon, Schwann cells, myelin sheath, nodes of Ranvier. Then we discussed about the type classification on the basis of structure. We have multipolar, we have unipolar, we have bipolar, and we have pseudopolar. On the basis of function, we have motor, sensory, and interneurons. Interneurons are divided into projection or relay neuron, and the other one is local interneuron. Hope this video was informative for you guys. Please give us your feedback so we can improve in the next videos. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to get our latest new videos and explanations. Thanks for watching.